now, digging that up if it's not right at your fingertips. Liaison reports, I imagine, will be quick. I checked in with Cindy on planning, and I don't see Ed. So we'll move right into quick discussion about Sharrows. Probably the meat of the meeting tonight, the bike pedestrian master plan updates. Discuss safe routes to schools. September's coming right up, and new business. And just a quick preview of new business before I forget, and for Charlie's benefit, raise your hand if you're available and willing to meet August 4th.
I'm out of town. Yeah, no.
No
I'm out
Sam,
of town
no
too.
Peter. All right,
I think
so
I'm out of town the few days after that. I should be
okay,
there the
so
4th.
maybe this is our chance to finally find out if Jan is with us or not, and let him know that the August meeting depends on him for a quorum. See if we can get him in. But accepting that, we'll discuss it in new business. You know, I would like to go ahead and do some work towards safe routes to schools, but you know, even if we're not taking any votes. But I can live with skipping it as well. Okay, so again, liaison report. Let's review the minutes. I apologize. Does anybody not have the minutes that Peter emailed? I could put them up on the screen here if that would help.
Look good to me.
I don't see any issues, so I move that we accept those minutes and enter them into the record. Do I have a second on that?
Second.
Okay, roll call vote to enter the meetings. Myself, Mark Bailey, aye. Craig?
Aye.
Peter?
Aye.
David?
Aye.
Sam?
Aye.
Okay. Peter, remind me, are those minutes going somewhere? Maybe this is a question for Charlie as well. Are we set up so that if somebody asked us to point them towards the minutes of May or April, that those are going somewhere accessible, or is that, are we not quite there yet?
Yeah, I can send them wherever. If somebody gives me a place to point them to, I'll
Yeah, you
send
can send them over to me. I can post them.
them. What's your email address? Sorry.
CTIC
CTIC.
OTSKY at bedfordma.gov.
At bedfordma.gov. All right.
If you would be so kind, Peter, as to send him the full backlog of minutes.
I will do so.
And Charlie, hopefully that's not too much trouble.
Yeah, no problem.
But you know, inclusivity, accessibility, you know, that's all part of what we're trying to do here. Okay. So liaison reports, planning did not meet in May. So no updates there. Select board has been busy, but you know, again, not seeing Ed here, I won't speak for him. And I guess any, does anybody have anything they'd want to share from Friends of the Minuteman or other? Yeah, I could share a quick trails update as we're trying to keep a kind of informal, you know, liaison relationship there. But and anybody have anything to share?
No.
Oh. So Sharrows, I don't want to get too bogged down in this or maybe have a lot of back and forth, but you know, one of our priorities this you know, this year and as a committee in general, is getting getting Sharrows and just as importantly getting the accompanying you know, bikes may use full lane signs that kind of remind drivers what the Sharrows are intended to signify to drivers. It's apparent that you know, even folks you know, on the transportation committee you know, aren't really clear about you know, what's the purpose of Sharrows and what are the you know, how should they be done. I feel like I'm going out of focus here. So I thought it would make sense to at least have a discussion you know, for the record. You know, our committee supports Sharrows and bikes may use full lane signs, you know, as a key component right out of the bike pedestrian master plan. And we, you know, we advocate for care in where they're placed. You know, we advocate for care in where they're placed because they haven't always been positioned optimal distance from the curb. And there's always, you know, some nuance to, you know, kind of where specifically on the road they're positioned so they catch traffic that might be coming in at a certain point or whatever. So, you know, lots of opinions about Sharrows and certainly something that, you know, I think even among bike infrastructure advocates, there, you know, there's at least a degree of ambivalence about the impact of Sharrows. I think some people are very fond of throwing around a study that showed that Sharrows have essentially no, you know, over some duration had essentially no effect on bike safety for a given interval. But I, you know, I recall that being, you know, fairly anecdotal. But I, you know, I think I wanted to take at least 5 minutes just to, again, clarify the position of this committee and make sure that at least we are on the same page about Sharrows, and I'll just come out and say, you know, I think you know, Terry probably knows more about this stuff than I do, and maybe than many of us. And you know, he's often advocating for us to get some complete streets education and training. We'll touch on that as we get into the bike pedestrian master plan updates. But you know, if folks have questions about Sharrows, this is a great time to ask them. If folks would like to join me in, you know, kind of, you know, accepting Terry's call to, you know, that we really should be more trained up on complete streets and things like that, and want to try to make that happen, this is a great time to talk about that. So does anybody have any, am I basically right that we're all believers in Sharrows, and you know, that you know, probably something that we're overdue for, you know, here in town is bikes may use full lane signs, you know, kind of at those key points. And you know, I think of Pine Hill Road as the kind of classic example of a road that just begs for Sharrows, being narrow and twisty with a 25 mph you know, speed limit. It's the perfect example. So a great opportunity to educate drivers you know, there in ways that could apply elsewhere. So any thoughts or comments about Sharrows or questions people have?
Go ahead.
Well, I was just going to say, I remember that this study being brought up, and then Terry argued against it. You know, he had some ideas about how, you know, its shortcomings. You know, he had technical questions.
Yeah.
I personally, I mean, you know, I don't believe it is a solution to anything. It might raise some awareness. I wouldn't want the town of Bedford to like put some in and say, "Hey, we're doing something." Right? It's about the least you could possibly do. That's sort of my opinion. It's a one half step toward doing something reasonable.
Yeah, and I'm thinking of also there's like a place in Cambridge where they switched to Sharrows on Mass Ave because for two blocks they didn't have a bike lane. And you know, yeah, it seemed like a sop. You know, if, geez, sorry we couldn't have put a bike lane right here. Here's some Sharrows. But at the same time,
I mean, if you could make them really bright, really stand out, put in some signage. Now, there are bikes. It's just these, you know, standard white color. They just don't stand out enough as far as.
Well, I think the one thing is that they do is they're, and this may be what they're designed for, is to remind people that bicycles exist and yeah. that they have a right, and that the almost sign that they should put out there is bicycles have a right to be on this road.
No.
And so and oh god. I was thought it was good that Terry actually dug up the what is it? MUTCD reference. I don't know if anybody else has seen that. That's called the Manual of Uniform Traffic Control Devices. And I saw a reference to it on some bike list or something. And it also mentioned that there's a guy out there on TikTok making TikToks about barriers to bicycling. But I did find it. There's a draft. I think the official one you have to pay for, but there's a draft you can look at online. And it's rather large. But it has some good stuff in there.
David, Sam, any thoughts or questions?
I quite enjoy placing myself on the Sharrow when I'm making corners. And to be honest, I can't remember a car encroaching when I'm doing that. Whereas if I'm on the side of the road, they're always passing, you know, on the other side of double yellow lines if there is one around a corner. So I'm quite happy with them. Education is tricky, other than, like I say, being there, the car behind me says, oh, okay, that's what that's for. And the bike's supposed to be there. I don't know that any sign is going to do it. And there are too many signs. I don't know.
Yeah.
I tend to agree. It's sort of like the last option that, you know, last ditch option when you really can't get anything else. But in a place like Pine Hill Road, we're not going to rebuild the road. I don't see the town doing anything else. So, you know, that's what we can get. You know, there's other places where I would advocate, you know, there is more space. We can get a real bike lane. We can get something else. And we put our efforts there but definitely where we can't get anything, like Pine Hill Road, like Page Road too, I think we certainly should put in Sharrows as a minimum.
Yeah, I don't really know. Did we ever get Sharrows on Davis Road?
I don't.
That's the loop. The loop that goes past the school.
Yeah.
No, I know. I ride that route all the time. Mm-hmm. I've never seen.
Okay, because I've recently decided that the piece between Concord Road and the school is one of the more dangerous parts of the roads in town. Because it's narrow and has a high curb.
On 62?
No, between 62 and the school.
Oh, that little piece when you go past the church.
Right. It and only in that direction, because they've got a nice fat granite curb right there, like 3 inches from the white line.
Yeah.
Yeah, that area is also a real problem. It's such a natural spot for a safe route to Davis School from the reformatory branch for kids. Yeah. But cars entering town just come screaming over that hill at 50 miles an hour, and it's just impossible to imagine, you know.
Yeah, but even if they did make it over 62, they're still on Davis Road.
Yeah.
Well, the plan is a little trail, a back route through the swamp.
Oh. I mean, has DPW's attitude changed at all? Because, you know, whatever, 5 years ago or so, we had a big discussion, just a Sharrow discussion. And, you know, there were some obvious places where it was needed. And we just got massive pushback saying, oh, no, it'll just confuse the driver.
I see progress. 5 years ago, we didn't have Jeanette. And I think the fact that in addition to prioritizing Sharrows for key areas that we had the chance to weigh in on, the fact that we're also putting up as many as 10 bikes may use full lane signs to complement the Sharrows is an example of positive change at DPW. Okay. Any other quick thoughts on Sharrows? Yeah,
I wonder that digital sign that sometimes we try to use, but it's always on the busy side. We can't. You know, bike to school days and such. Couple of weeks if it's free, education, blinking by the DPW building about, you know, Sharrows, what they are. I don't know if that sign can show a Sharrow in ASCII.
Yeah, yeah. I don't know if it has, how many characters, I guess you could.
Well, we can figure it out.
Yeah.
It's a great chance to be succinct. I love that idea.
And the other thing I was thinking is that we may have, although I don't know, there's going to be an opportunity here because presumably Adrian's going to be replaced. And we can try to get on her replacement's good side.
Here, here. Always been a priority since I took the helm of this little.
And but somebody will be coming in fresh. Mm-hmm. And so.
Yeah, great thoughts. Is anyone game for David? Would you be up for emailing? Let's see. I'm trying to think of who we'd ask about that sign. I know I've talked to them about that during bike to school day stuff. You know, my big idea, of course, is for the big highway sign over Route 3 before the exit through Bedford to say, you know, student bike traffic in Bedford, seek alternate route. Because trucks and cars driving at highway speeds through our town when kids are biking to school through crosswalks because the highway isn't fast enough for them. It nothing makes me more angry than that. Anyway, now we get to the fun part of the meeting that I tried to dump off on Craig and Sam, but with gratitude to one of our public attendees, cried foul on open meeting law to have that discussion. So we get to do it together. And, you know, I'll bring up the document and show you all what I'm, you know, basically what I'm thinking. And I've got one idea for how we might have a prayer of getting through this without getting too bogged down, but I haven't thought about it much. So I would very much welcome others' thoughts about this. Maybe I'll try putting this on another screen. No, I don't want it on the screen.
I've had some thoughts while you're looking for that about Terry's email about the redoing of the 5 E's.
Yeah.
And I spent a lot of time studying that today, partially because I couldn't find this document. It's sitting there right on my hard disk, but I didn't recognize it. I think that's not quite ready for prime time. It's on the they're redoing the five. I think if we wanted to go for a bicycle friendly community designation, it would be part of it. But in terms of the description, in terms of the rewrite, even their stuff is not complete yet.
Fair enough.
And it was also sort of how to morph from one to the other. They did not offer a how to get from one to the other plan. They just gave a couple of examples, which was in that thing that Terry sent. Okay, you. I see your.
Okay, so this is from Carla, and this Word document is intended to complement the bike pedestrian master plan, you know, as has been, you know, mentioned in our meetings. The plan suggests, you know, regular updates about our progress. That's one of the responsibilities of this committee. You know, one big point to make, this is non-infrastructure stuff. The whole scope of this is not about building new, you know, protected, you know, bike infrastructure. It's, you know, it's far more around these softer ease and even enforcement, I think, is less a focus. In any case, the way this document works, I think each of you should have this or have access to it. And any member of the public who wants it can simply request it from me or Charlie, I guess. We've got it's a long document, and there's a number of responsible parties. So, you know, I have the privilege of attending the Healthy Bedford Safe Routes to Schools meetings that are hosted by Carla Olson. That's a heck of a collection of really dedicated people, from key folks at Public Works, you know, principals of the schools, you know, Transportation Committee, Healthy Bedford folks. It's a great meeting, and I'd welcome any of y'all who want to come along. Anyway, you know, this lists a bunch of recommendations, and they have a certain priority, and they have a certain number of responsible parties. And my suggestion, I'll just find an example of where we're mentioned. So here's a medium priority recommendation where we are one of three responsible parties. And this is the one I referenced earlier. You know, I personally would love to have some complete streets training that would allow me to be a very, you know, current and informed consultant to the town, as, you know, for example, if they're coming to us saying, where should this Sharrow go? You know, I would love to be, you know, to really feel confident that that I'm following current best practices in my recommendations. So, you know, this is, and in terms of providing our updates, our basic purpose in this component of the meeting is to actually update this. And I'm tracking changes here, so you know, so we can actually mark this up. And I would then provide the updates back to Carla. And you know, with some luck, the other stakeholders referenced here would do the same, and those would continue to be consolidated. And as we want to continue to update them, we can. You know, this is an example of one I think that you know, that really has no recent update. You know, some of the responsible parties have weighed in there, and this would be our opportunity to.
I would say, and I don't really know exactly how to say it. Is this looks like it was treated as a one and done? We got some training in 2016. Now the BAC we actually haven't had any.
Training. So raise your hand if you'd like to join me in at least a day of complete streets training.
I mean, this would be a day during the week. I mean, I'm not really available. Well, sorry, if it's on a Friday, on certain Fridays, I'm available.
Let's say it's a day that we have the chance to plan for well in advance. Yeah. So at least three of us.
Yeah. I get every second Friday off. I'm on one of these 980 schedules. So planning for one of those Fridays, I'm all in.
I mean, I'm kind of curious what, you know, what this means that they completed all complete streets training available. That's a, you know, that's a pretty bold statement. I wonder how many hours that takes.
How long has Jacinda been on the planning board?
How long has the what?
Jacinda been on the planning board? Would she have been involved in the section, the training involved in the
possible
second paragraph?
I mean, it looks here, DPW looks like it's been 3 years since they updated their training. Right. So we should join one of them, right?
Yeah, yes. We should basically, when they have a new training, because if nothing else, maybe they're, presumably they've brought new people on board.
Yep.
I mean, this was last updated May 2019, right? So they could easily have already been there twice since then, right?
Right, yes. Again, in theory, the same document is in their hands for them to provide their updates. So with some luck as part of this process. And as a quick point of process, I'm not necessarily hoping to have a completely final, revised document here, free of any typos, and ready to send off to Carla. I'm gonna, in some cases we might be taking notes here, or actually putting responses in.
I mean, I'm not convinced, right? I've not seen much evidence that DPW really watches out for complete streets.
Right.
Are engaged with it, right? They may or may not know what it is, but I have not seen any evidence that they're actually actively engaged with it. So maybe if we join them, we can exert some friendly pressure.
Well, our commitment to complete streets doesn't have any teeth.
Well, there you go.
And, I recall attending one of the old Billericay Road, hearings where our consultant, was presenting their design of, adding two right turn lanes onto old Billericay Road. And the consultant got up and said, this is one of three complete streets projects that we're working on. And I wanted to just ask, in what, there is not an inch of consideration for bicycles or pedestrians in this plan.
Yeah.
In what way is this a complete streets project? Are the other ones equally ambitious? I really wanted to ask. Anyway.
But I think if we were to join DPW, some of us would join the DPW person for this training, we would then have some real ammunition, right? And say, remember.
Yes.
Hour, 10 minutes, or 10 minutes past nine, whatever, this particular trainings, item. Remember that?
Yep. Yeah,
I think that would
it creates a common language or, common framework for our discussions.
Yeah. An opportunity for shaming. We need shaming opportunities. Yeah. Anyway, yeah, so if it can be done on one of my Fridays, I'm all in.
Okay. So my thought, again, this is a rather long document, and my quick thought is to endeavor, if nothing else, that any high priority item where we are, one of not too many responsible parties, I'd like to focus, as much of our attention on that first as I can, and then we'll see how much medium and lower priority stuff, we need to get through. But for now, we'll just keep scanning for... And obviously, we should be weighing in on many of these things. But for now, for example, here's, it's fair to say, I think we should be a responsible party here, right? I mean,
yeah.
We are part of, through me and Ralph, we are part of Healthy Bedford. But straight up, we belong here. I'm sorry.
Well, I would add there, BAC is already very active, or some of us are at any rate.
Oh, sure.
Would like to be officially added as a responsible party.
Right. I mean, I could add any amount of kind of progress. BAC is at least mentioned here. So I mean, this is at least slightly current you know, update, which is accurate. You know, that effective, you know, as of this date is when Lane School, you know, really stepped out of kind of top-down leadership of it, and it, you know, began to be more of that grassroots spirit. Okay, so, you know, we want to be at it as a responsible party. And, you know, I'll try to draft at least a couple points about what we believe we, you know, what progress we believe we've made that's not reflected here. I'm not going to try to do that now. So for now, I'll just say, I'm going to do that now. Okay, so here's a high priority one that we're at the top of the list for, right? So, you know, I think it's fair, you know, I think it's fair to say that we, you know, like we just talked about, we, you know, we would advocate for the town to more actively consider the complete streets policy in every move that's taken. I think it's generous to say it's a secondary consideration.
They received a score of 100. The planning board says completed in May 16. How they received a score of 100. I'm assuming that's out of 100.
One would have, maybe it is.
Or out of 1,000, who knows?
But yeah, we definitely, doesn't feel like, you know, unless that plan is yet to be implemented, that was warranted.
There you go.
Well, whatever they did, they got their money, probably.
Yeah. So, you know, we did get grants for Hartford Press and Bacon. I mean, this is one of the points that, you know, that's worth pointing out. Anywhere where we're taking funding, you know, it's a little bit frustrating to see us take funding from Complete Streets grants and then not prioritize the, you know, the non-car elements of that. That just doesn't feel right.
Yeah, I mean, the 100 score is on the plan, right? Not on the implementation.
Yeah, and if nothing else, for the planning board, that's 5 years old.
Yeah.
I mean, I think it's fair to say that that there's evidence of progress as we consider the North Road intersection.
Yeah.
Right. That's a sign. You know, we didn't have to fight for every inch of accommodation there. Right. Would you all agree?
Right. And also the North Road sidewalk, mm-hmm. the way they said they're putting in a bike lane. You know.
Does anybody have anything else they feel we should say here in our update?
Once again, it just to be installed summer 2019. You know, it's also it's sort of obvious that everybody else should be updating this too.
Yeah, just assume they are.
Yeah,
it'll be great.
Yeah, I guess what we have to do.
Let's lead the way. When they see our awesome updates, they'll be inspired. I think we basically have consensus on this committee that we don't think we have any case to make for being more friendly than the last time.
Well,
I mean, I would say that's a waste of time until we actually do something.
That right. I would say that the responsible parties are wrong. And HB, that Healthy Bedford, saying that basically, there's a fair amount of stuff in the application that would require knowledge from TAC and or DPW that requires knowledge of a paid professional. I mean, there's even things, you know, like, do you have a bicycle coordinator, a paid bicycle coordinator? If so, is it full time, or what tenths of a time? You know, that kind of thing. There's just a ton of stuff in there that, you know, I have the document up here, but I don't think I can share it in any way on this. There's just a ton of stuff that really the friends and the, I don't know who did it in the past, but I don't see how we could get a high score without DPW's and tax cooperation.
Okay, so we believe TAC should be added.
Yes, we believe TAC should be added as that, and that it would filling out the application would require a significant amount of information from DPW.
But we don't believe we ever, if we applied for this right now, we'd get anything different than we have today, right?
No, but I think it is, doesn't Lexington have it?
Yeah.
Okay, because I had the
bronze.
Okay, I did also in reading the application, I got the impression that we're on the small side for their target community, and therefore we probably can't afford some stuff. But we'll see.
I think if you look at bicycle friendly communities, you would find any number that are.
Oh, I'm certain. Yeah, there is some place where they sort of give you a thing of, you know, how much. There is a place where they say how big you are, and they're talking, you know, how many bike shops do you have, and then they say, well, one for 1 to 15,000, and you know, things like that.
Sure. Does anybody?
I mean, what I would say is that when our Minuteman extension gets finally put in, is that like a year? That would be that would I would incur that would be a timing, a good timing. If that gets put in, that would be a massive thing to advertise. You know,
right.
That would be a good time to start pulling things together.
And also some of these bike lanes, they talk a lot about bike lanes and stuff like that.
Yeah, I mean, the Minuteman extension is a huge contribution by us to the region.
Yeah.
So it should be, I agree 100%, Peter. Great thought.
Incidentally, go ahead.
There you go. Kind of hoping that at that same time we presumably will have done, you know, North Road, and that'll have become the new, you know, kind of standard for the amount of accommodation we build in, and that there would be, you know, a number of other things we could point to.
I did have a discussion, an email exchange with Jennifer, because there's a bunch of DigSafe markings all over Railroad Ave, and Jennifer assured me that they have nothing to do with the work, which is scheduled for 2023.
I thought there was a rumor it could actually get moved up to 22 again.
Well, she did not say if it was calendar year 2023 or fiscal year 2023.
It about 6 months ago, it got bumped to 23, or I don't know, that's probably 8 months ago, who knows.
Right.
But Ed or somebody mentioned recently, a month or two ago, that there was some talk of, because of things sliding around, that it could actually get bumped back up to 22, just because it's, you know, whatever, shovel ready and
well, yeah, well, that's the reason why the fiscal issue.
Yep.
Because we're in 22 fiscally.
Right. Biking events. So here's an opportunity to weigh in on on events. We, you know, I think one of the things, you know, as a commuter to Boston in normal times, one of the ideas I've always loved the thought of, but haven't participated in myself, would be a, you know, Saturday, but, you know, if people who are thinking of commuting into Boston or Cambridge for the first time and don't want to do so, and what I learned today is a, you know, increase in very real traffic, that doing like a Saturday morning ride into Boston, so a new commuter can get comfortable with that route without the rush hour traffic, can then, you know, make it easier for them to get started biking to work, and you know, as well, perhaps, you know, regular Friday rides in the fall of you know, from Depot Park to Longfellow Bridge or whatever. And you know, there's a couple of
typically, like, what's the length of that commute
from Bedford to Boston? It's 15 miles.
So people, it's like an hour and a half most of the time, you think?
That sounds about right.
Bedford to Boston, it gets a little slower once you get past Alewife.
Yeah,
I do it in under an hour, but I push pretty hard.
Yeah, I used to figure out going to Alewife, I used to figure an hour going towards Alewife and an hour and a quarter coming from Alewife because the hill's bigger.
Yeah.
And then I could easily see it's another half hour past Alewife.
Right.
How do you go to, we've discussed this before, right? You know, there's, it's an art to get from Alewife to Boston.
Yeah.
Except if it involves locking your bike up and catching the T.
I have what do we want to say about, I mean, this is medium priority, I don't want to get too bogged down here, but what do we want to say about this in the form of an update? We haven't weighed in on this at all. You know, I think we're active, you know, promoters of active transit in general. You know, I think Active Transit Month back before the pandemic, where we had that calendar of events, that was a, you know, that was a pretty successful initiative.
Special biking.
Yeah.
I mean, I used to lead the one at the Boston Government Center. It was monthly, then it turned into every May bike week. And I expect to do that again when it starts back up again. And I personally extended it from Bedford to Concord. So there's that. I think as a group, the Bedford Minuteman group volunteered to shuttle anyone anytime to learn their commute by bike. And I think that's still an offer. I don't know that how it was ever advertised other than word of mouth. You know, with the Bedford Day, we talked about it
here. Yeah, great.
There is something here is that looking at the definition, I don't know how special it has to be, but there is the weekly ride from the Council on Aging.
Yeah.
Which has, actually, we get about half a dozen Bedford people and then maybe a dozen non-Bedford people. I have to step away right now, though.
I'm not sure if this fits here, but is somebody still doing the middle school bike training thing for, you know, the gym class thing, or is that kaput now? You know, Dave and Terry were doing it for a few years.
Yeah, both Job and Davis, and yeah, actually, we even went to, I guess you call it the middle school, the one next to the high school. It's kind of no longer done. We kept getting pushback from the gym teachers because they were being pressured because of, you know, teach to the test. And I think the latest iteration was we brought in Mass Bike, hey, you know, let's teach the teachers. And that never, you know, other than a one rodeo day, and they never kicked off as far as I'm aware.
Yeah, we, I might have dropped that ball as much as anyone, because we did have a dialogue with them. And, you know, I think that that opportunity to get some train the trainer training for us from Mass Bike on offering those rodeos, that was a blast. And the, you know, the image of some kids, you know, getting on a bike who actually hadn't really been on a bike, you know, for the first time was still brings tears to my eyes. it's good stuff. So, I mean, we have a new principal coming into the middle school, and, you know, I have a daughter coming into the middle school. So I suddenly have an interest. I mean, you know, we all know that the, you know, people, you know, kids get hooked on biking to school to Lane, and the, you know, the ridership to the middle school is always quite high. But with a new principal coming into the middle school, I will try to lead that charge. And, you know, I think, you know, that I could, maybe I'll be strategic and kind of have Carla bring that up instead of myself. What did we call that? Middle school PE education?
Yeah, it sounds about right. I don't think there's anything specific about it. You know, we brought a number of bikes into the gym and helmets were shared. Did some basic training, and then everyone got a chance to do some skills.
But didn't they have a bunch of bikes that they actually used, ones, whatever, that they stored there? Are those still stored there somewhere?
They're not. We were told to purge, and we purged. Bikes Not Bombs got them all.
Okay.
So here's something I haven't thought about much. God knows there's plenty of groups that bike through our town. How about publicizing and expanding recreational biking groups in the area? Charles River Wheelers, Cycle Works.
Yeah, I would say Charles River Wheelman for sure, if we could, you know, do something with them. The bicycle stores typically lead rides, and I find them quite dangerous when they're on the Minuteman and I'm crossing paths with them, because they don't instill safety to the riders at all.
Does the bikeway stores do anything like that?
I haven't heard about them at all.
Yeah.
Quad stands out, like I say, as, you know, aggressive.
Yeah, there still is. Well, actually, I don't know. Did we put down? How do we? This is the distinction between special ones and special ones and regular ones. And actually, for the last few years, the president of the CRW has been a Bedford resident, but it's not, but he's no longer president, but he's still
a great place to start. Who knows him?
Jack Donahue. So when I think there's a bunch of people on this CRW, right, with the Council on Aging Rights, who are much more active in CRW than I am.
Would you try to arrange an introduction to me?
Okay.
I'll try to run with it.
Yeah, he's no longer the current president. He was
just to start.
His name was.
We should try to get him on this committee.
Here. I'd love to make progress in that direction. I'm a huge fan of Charles River Wheelmen or Wheel people. What do they call themselves?
Wheelers.
Wheelers. Awesome.
And what did you mention, the COA ride?
Yes,
somewhere
we
said earlier. It should be mentioned. That's okay. That's a regular ride, not a But there is one or more CRW rights that come out of Bedford.
Yeah, I mean, it's a group that we should be connected to.
Yeah.
Boy, here's one I like the look of. This is a component of the progress we've been trying to make, you know, here as we get into summer, making sure that that the select board always knows what significant, you know, what small, medium, and large things are kind of on our short list as our top recommendations. And I fighting for a dedicated funding program that would be a budget from which we could, you know, we could do smaller stuff. What a lovely idea.
Let's see. Well, this is, DPW actually goes down to fit FY19.
Okay.
$1.3 million for bike ped improvements, ped bike shelters, bunches of it. Okay.
This, so what do we want to say to this?
I don't know if we're ready. See, basically, if you know that we've been discussing with Ed how we recommend things.
Right, and capital expenditures. That's
well, not nominally. It says basically we recommend to the selectmen, and the selectman recommends to DPW.
Right.
The pedestrian aspect was added to the budget. You know, it's now official. Sidewalks have a place, not just, you know, scrap money that's left behind. Yeah. And talking about the master plan, you know, one thing I noticed was the Bacon Hartford sidewalk, one side was completed. So.
Mm-hmm.
And there are also those various new, well, we can talk about what's happened. You know, there's various new either automatic or manual pedestrian crosswalk sign.
Yeah, I think there's room for that. I think that was covered somewhere above as, I don't want to get.
But in terms of an ongoing line item in the budget, that would presumably be a line item in the DPW budget.
Right.
We could say we're continuing to work for it.
I mean, it's, you know, the point is it's the town's capital expenditure. I think who executes it, I think there could be some instances where it's not 100% the DPW.
Well, I think we'll go back to the, go back to that where we were, the one we're talking about now.
I know, I went looking for the update on the crosswalk.
Budget, I think, might be a certain.
All right.
Why don't you search for budget? It's encouragement recommendation number 9.
Thank you. Anything to say here? I think we're not going to. I don't want to spend too much more time on this tonight.
Well, I would almost say that one thing is to me, is this a funding program? We should talk about both operating and operating and capital.
And more permanent, yeah, recurring stuff like snow clearing or weeds.
Right,
and infrastructure stuff, sure.
And we should probably mention something about budgeting to clear the extension. I don't know exactly what this seems.
What do you want to say here, Craig? I just wanted to get that out.
Yeah, that in particular, we need to be budgeting now to make sure we have the resources to maintain the Minuteman extension when
as
it's built.
As it doubles. Yeah.
We've
mentioned that, and that is
right, but we haven't mentioned it in writing.
Yeah.
I would make a separate sentence. I would make it as recommends, yeah, planning now for the maintenance of the.
I mean, I know we're on record discussing this, I think, with DPW in the room.
Yeah.
But I agree, this is as good a place as any.
I wouldn't even, right. Maintenance, I would say maintenance, including snow clearing. Mm-hmm. Because, you know, it's, there's going to be tree roots, what have you.
Yep. Okay. I want to focus the remainder of our time, we're not even halfway through this document, on what this document considers to be high priority items. And so I'm just doing a quick scan. I think it's kind of sorted.
It's in each section starts with high priority.
You know, I think that with Officer Jeff retiring, you know, probably worth, you know, remembering that we should have a new school safety officer coming on that we'll want to, you know, build a relationship with.
You may want to even designate a school safety slash, well, a generalized sort of waving my hands here, but you know, sort of a bicycle specialist at the police department,
mm-hmm.
who would be familiar with and would provide training in bicycle in both bicycle and pedestrian issues. And as I said,
And I mean, Tom Devine is as close as we have to that right now.
Right, and he's a traffic guy.
Yeah.
I wonder if Mass Bike, I know they did a video specifically with the Boston Police Department Academy, and I think the Transit Police as well, you know, if they have or could start up a program where they talk to the local police departments. You have sessions of training for that type of a connection.
Yeah.
You know, yeah, not just a person, but let's improve all of their smarts.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
But I'm sort of okay, I'm waffling on this because it doesn't necessarily have to be in the BPD.
Yeah.
We want them to be trained, and it would be good to have somebody to whose job description includes the training, and it could be a DPW person. or yeah. something else.
Yeah, and to that end, mass bike training DPWs around the area, because clearly none of them understand bikes at all.
Right. That's one of the things in the bicycle friendly community thing, is that you get more points if you actually are paying somebody.
Yeah. How much of that do you want to try to stuff into here?
I think we're probably, I think, well, actually, we could just say, we could just recommend the town. Actually, maybe we recommend the town have a trained bicycle specialist without specifying which department's in.
Yeah, I feel like
the police.
But I love the idea of a cop.
Right.
You know, with that. Well,
Mark, also put your Friday night hat on. And remember that the LAB is de-emphasizing the involvement of, they're taking the word sure. police out of many of their guidelines and just sure. saying community. Does the police track bicycle accidents? Does your community track bicycle accidents?
Right, I'm going to leave that there for now and just keep hunting
The English could be polished a little, but that's
always.
Yeah, that's for your English teacher.
My wife's an editor.
Oh, well, that's good to have around.
You know, I can't help but weigh in on this because I, you know, have to be routinely appalled by seeing, you know, cars just blazing through crosswalks with school children in them. I don't see much of this.
Yeah. This is more oriented towards PET.
Not enough. I mean, in our town.
Well, no, but I mean,
along the Great Road, the kids are on the sidewalk, and
this particular statement has been more oriented towards pedestrians.
But still, you know, bicycles crossing
can be pedestrian. Right, and that's something we recommend stepped up enforcement or what have
you. Yeah, I've only locally seen active, you know, ticketing presence in Arlington on Mass Ave.
Look at the last sentence of the line before. We could say BAC will recommend supports BPD in this additional funding.
Mm, uh-huh.
Yeah. Because. No, I would just say, okay.
Okay. Bad driver reporting program. Good stuff.
click it or ticket.
It's DPW, Healthy Bedford, DPW. I mean, there's a lot of stuff in here we're going to want to weigh in on. But we're going to keep moving through it. So here's one that looks like it's got bicycle friendly community in mind. Phase 3 Middlesex Turnpike.
Okay. Where we're on engineering 6. Okay.
Yeah, for now.
Okay. We just, all we can say is we continue.
Let's get from past 0%. Then we'll worry about the 78%.
Yeah, I mean, do we know what percent?
Right.
Whatever. It's certainly less than 10%.
Yeah. I mean, and what do we need for bronze?
Yeah, that I have not figured out. You can mention the North Road sidewalk with the North Road bike path, basically, bike lane.
North Road bike lane?
Yeah. Because Jennifer said that when I was complaining about the vertical the vertical curb, she said, well, there it's in a 5-foot bike lane. I said, okay, yeah, that's a 4-foot bike lane.
Yeah, I mean, we've talked about that. I mean, we advocate for slanted curbs where we're really fighting for every inch. But, you know, DPW obviously prefers, you know, vertical curbs. And you know, my view is, you know, if we've got enough room for that 5 feet in the vertical curb, I'll take that over right. Fighting for
inches. Oh, yeah. Like but I think there, and that actually is a point, is the person who pushed back against the vertical curb there has now retired.
Yeah.
Yes, this is a very good that the we should note is that restenciling. We definitely recommend the restenciling of the hot spot for. Triggering traffic lights, and that has not been done since, for example, the South Road Loomis. Call it hotspots.
Okay.
It's where the bicycle's supposed to be. I actually have an email from Adrian, which indicates some of the where they are and some where they aren't.
Yeah, I thought substantially all of the lights were supposed to have them.
No, actually, some of the ones on Great Road, Adrian didn't even know. She said, oh, the state did that.
Okay, I mean, I think it's fair to say we, you know, Sharrow's, you know, we could be a little more frequent with.
Well, and also, the re-stenciling the hotspots and recommend, we also should recommend that the hot spots be evaluated annually for correct operation.
Sure. I mean, for now, that's on us. You know,
right.
DPW's position is they work. It's on us to go test them.
But it's incredibly hard to test it unless you do it at 2 a.m.
Sure. Whatever.
I'll say regular testing.
Yep. Okay. Yeah, and okay. I think we recommend more regular, you know, restriping of bicycle facilities.
Well, yeah, I would maybe make that I wouldn't hide that down in one sentence. Because I would. I wanted to, yes, we should have the, that there's a notable deficiency because I think it's been 5 years since that South Road Loomis intersection was repaved. And they, as I understand it, they didn't even own the stencil.
I'm tempted to weigh in on this. I like the idea of wheel guards. for safety, but I'm going to keep moving.
Yeah.
So here's one. You know, I think we, you know, we could give ourselves mixed grades for, you know, for how we do on this, but
okay. I would say, first of all, we should take out the gates rather than just, we recommend that you take out the gates, not just considering taking out the gates. Bollards are fun.
And paving the narrow gauge trail.
Well, I would take that, once again, I wouldn't make that one sentence. In the future, as a future consideration, there should be future consideration to paving the narrow gauge.
All right, I'm going to find one more thing we can update, and we're going to call this a wrap.
Wait a minute. Go back on that other one. There was one other thing I just thought.
We were here.
Something about brush clearing. I don't know where that goes. This is not specifically that. And Ed has responded to that, but we can say supports, the AC supports brush to keep rights of way open.
Awesome.
And where you are there before you, well, you just went away. C-click fix, the town dropped that up years ago.
Yeah, and that's mentioned there. I wonder if we
can't bring something back like that.
Yeah, I would say I was thinking about that because the advantage of C-click
years ago,
it was an app. And whereas now the official thing is to call or use their webpage. Which using their web page, it shouldn't. I don't even know if it's a responsive web page.
Yeah, there was a really cool. There was that article that Terry shared about bike safety, and Jan weighed in on that. And there was a really cool app or website mentioned in there that you know, we could absolutely begin logging crashes, near misses, safety issues, etc.
This is really different. Cool.
I can't remember it,
Mark. This is different. This is reporting potholes. And it's open. It's not bicycle specific.
Yeah. Okay.
Recommends that there be a well-documented method for every citizen. I don't even know how to say this. For every well-documented that can be used with a mobile phone. Method for issues to be reported using a mobile phone.
Sure.
I think they want you to hyphenate it.
Of course.
Okay.
Wayfinding, right? So this has been discussed as part of the grant.
Yes.
And it feels like that, that something could, at least in terms of recommendations.
We believe in wayfinding.
Yeah. Okay. Bike maintenance stations, that would be great. Shared parking ordinance.
That's low.
Bicycle parking. Review and update the bicycle and pedestrian plan every 2 years. Here yeah. we are, right? So this is what we're supposed to be doing. And we'll see. Walking audits annually. That sounds like a lot of fun.
And give that to Ralph.
Crash data. Here's something that's come up in some of those recent discussions.
We don't know how to do that.
Well, so I think Terry was in the habit of periodically right. asking the police for reports, you know, of specific incidents.
Well, yeah, I was going to say we should get updated training on how to access these data.
Okay, folks, I think we're going to, we should be doing we're better on bike up. Counts. You know, I think we'd like to have, we didn't quite pull our weight in the most recent count, but there are opportunities to do that again in fall. But wouldn't it be great to have counters like Arlington and Lexington has?
Yeah, but even for wealthy Lexington, they depended on manna from heaven.
And Susie and I did participate, so.
Thank you.
Yeah, I did. I counted.
Didn't mean to minimize that, David. Thank you.
I counted as well.
Thank you.
And then proceeded to get sick.
Right. So we pulled our weight. Okay. demonstration part. Yeah, I think there's a lot more good stuff here. I'm going to go ahead and save this for now. See if we can send it to Carla. At least as some update. If it causes some discussion, then that's great. For now, it's getting very close to our scheduled stop time. You know, safe routes to schools. I think all I need to say on that is that I think this fall.
What's the time frame for the fall?
So there's going to be I think turning it into an active transit month with a whole calendar of events is a beautiful thing. The 2021 bike to school day is.
We're in 2021, 22 now.
I know.
The last year
one? Fall 21. Okay. There is a day. I can't recall the date. October 6th.
Okay, we may want to do
a walk and bike to school day.
We may actually, it would be interesting to do counts that day.
Yeah. Yeah, I was doing some informal counting at Lane School. We had some, if I recall from previous years, we had some record. We had some really great Fridays
right. Because I think the middle school will actually have the largest
yeah. class. Anyway, so you know, gearing up towards October 6th again, from day one I want kids biking. I think parents may continue to be uncomfortable putting unvaccinated kids on buses and sick of waiting in those lines like on Sweetwater that Sam and I wade our way through. Lots of education, evangelism, encouragement, hopefully leveraging our regional coordinator who's gonna help me with like maps of, for example, of the ride that I lead that could be kind of distributed so people knew where they could meet up with us when. So, you know, I was kind of hoping to touch on that heavily in August, but we're not meeting in August. So watch for that to dominate the agenda on in September. I'll endeavor to have discussed those recent changes we made to that document with Carla before our meeting in September. I don't recall right now when the next Healthy Bedford meeting is. It may be before September, in which case I'll let you all know how it goes. I don't have that answer now. Any thoughts, comments on Safe Routes to School? It'll be Sam's first time with us for that. I know I've got a great ally in you, Sam. So we're gonna rock it. It's gonna be, there's gonna be more kids than ever biking to Lane School if we do our job right.
Yeah. Davis School is the one I just, again, with the just there's no good way on 62 to get kids doing a longer bike ride than just from the parking lot.
I know.
To the school, unfortunately, but.
I know. I think it's honestly, it's a traffic light and a sign at the top of the hill that says red light ahead.
Yeah.
And then the crosswalk and then the trail that we had applied for.
Yeah.
That would go, back between the church and the houses there. It's tricky.
Couldn't you access? What about accessing it from Glen Ridge?
Yeah, that's how kids do it, and what a lovely neighborhood to ride through. I mean, that's a great ride. And there's that back path.
Yeah. And there's a catch up.
So that's what you do. Even there, the crossing is appalling. I have personally witnessed small kids almost getting killed in that crosswalk right in front of their parents. So progress to be made, but you're absolutely right, Craig. That's that's the way to do it today. My only new business was to ask about the August 4th meeting, and I think we've agreed not to do that. Charlie, if you're still paying attention, bless you for one thing, and there's your answer on August 4th.
And then just heads up on kind of the future of meetings, the select board, I think it's on their agenda for August 9th to discuss kind of what their guidance is going to be for virtual versus in-person. So stay tuned on that. You may have a choice, you may not, moving forward.
Who would meet in person in September if that were a choice? Raise your hand. Awesome. We'll try to make that happen if it's safe. Everyone's vaccinated. I'm allowed to ask that, right? You never know.
As long as we're not in Florida.
Okay. Folks, thanks for your patience as we waded our way through that long document. I think it's fair to say that we should revisit that, I don't know, quarterly or perhaps in a cadence with those Healthy Bedford Safe Routes to Schools and kind of do our part to get to let that be less stale.
When you Mark, when you get that polished up and I's dotted, could you distribute it?
Yes. I will copy you and sending it to Carla.
Yeah, if you can, but if you just copy everyone on the
And I'll make a point to copy that the broader public group as well. No reason to keep it close. Okay. Do I hear a motion to adjourn?
I so move.
Second. From Peter. All right, we'll go ahead and adjourn. I'll do that with a roll call vote. Myself, Mark Bailey, aye. Craig?
Aye.
David?
Aye.
Peter?
Aye.
Sam?
Aye.
Okay, folks, we're adjourned. Thank you so much. And thanks very much, Charlie. Thanks very much to Bedford TV.
Thanks, everybody.